Welcome to all. Today we'll discuss some illustrations of rationalizing factor, which is very important process in the chapter SADS.
Okay.
See, first we'll start with monomials.
First, let us find the rationalizing factor of under root of 75.
The square root of 75.
See, 75 is a pure SAD because another factor, see, it is only irrational number is there, another factor is rational number. We have to express in simple SAD form. So what we can do? 25 times 3 I can write 75. And I can use laws of radicals. That is root 25 times root 3. 25 is a square number. So that is 5 root 3. Okay, now it is simple SAD. Now I can write the rationalizing factor. 5 root 3 rationalizing factor is, if you multiply with root 3. What I am going to get LC? 5 times, again I will use the laws of radicals, 3 times 3, that is 3, 5 times 3 is 15. So I got a rational number. See, when you multiply a irrational number with another irrational number and you are getting a rational number, then one is the rationalizing factor of the other. So for root, therefore, rationalizing factor of root 75. And that too, simplest rationalizing factor of root 75 is root 3. See, here not only root 3, 2 root 3, 3 root 3, even for root 75 is also one rationalizing factor. It is not unique. We have to take the simplest ones. Okay, next, another example will give. If suppose cubed root of 36 like that is there. 36 means it is 6 square. But here if you are having 6 cube means then we can we'll get a rational number. So you have to multiply with cubed root of 6. See. Here easily we are able to identify. Actually there is a shortcut. See. What is the shortcut means? Nth root of a power m is there like that means. Then the rationalizing factor is. Okay, nth root of a power n minus mc. So how will you find the rationalizing factor of cubed root of 36? Cubed root of 6 power 3 minus 2. That is cubed root of 6. See, you multiply and check cubed root of 36 and cubed root of 6 you multiply. They are having same index. So what we can do? 36 into 6 you can write. 6 square into 6, 6 cube it is. So, cube and cube root will get cancelled and you will get a rational number. So, if the product of these two irrational numbers is a rational number, then one is the rationalizing factor of the other. The rationalizing factor of cube root of 36 means cube root of 6. Rationalizing factor of cube root of 6 means cube root of 36. Okay, why we do all this rationalization and all means? Some purpose is there. What is that purpose means?
In trigonometry or mensuration or any chapter, not only in 10th class, in higher classes.
Finally, the end result will be like this. 20 upon root 5.
I am saying some example. See, denominator you can't have irrational numbers. Irrational numbers means their decimal expansion is neither terminating nor repeating. So we can't divide any integer with irrational numbers.
So what we have to do?
We have to do rationalization of denominators.
Now we know rationalizing factor of root 5 is root 5. So I will multiply
both numerator and denominator with rationalizing factor, simplest rationalizing factor root 5. If you multiply numerator and denominator, value will not change.
So this is 20 times root 5. Root 5 into root 5, it is 5. 5 ones are, 5 fours are. So 4 times root 5 you got. So 4 times root 5 is a rational number, no? Some 2.236.
It won't terminate or it won't repeat also.
This 4, if you multiplying 4 times, it is easy than dividing with any integer with irrational number, no?
That's why we'll do rationalization. That too, rationalization of denominator.
Now we'll discuss some example for
binomial.
See, binomial, I will give one problem in competitive exam. If x is some root 3 minus root 2 like that they have given. root 3 plus root 2. Then find x square plus 1 by x square, like that. Then x is given anyway here, 1 by x we have to calculate. So 1 by x, so 1 by root 3 plus root 2.
So how to find the rationalizing factor of denominator means, see, it is in a plus b, no? We try to multiply with a minus b so that we can apply the algebraic idea.
So I'll multiply numerator and denominator with root 3 minus root 2. So that denominator, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So I can apply the identity a square minus b square. Here square, square root will get cancelled. Here also it will get cancelled. Root 3 minus root 2 I will get. Here 3 minus 2, that is 1. So finally what we are getting? Root 3 minus root 2.
See, when we are multiplying root 3 plus root 2 with root 3 minus root 2, we are getting a rational numbers. Then one is the rationalizing factor of the other. One is the rationalizing factor of other. See. Okay. Root A plus root B is there. Then its rationalizing factor is root A minus root B. Here if root A minus B, root A minus root B is there, means root A plus root B. When you multiply those two things, you can apply the algebraic identity A square minus B square and you can get a rational number. Okay, here not only rationalizing factor these are. See, 1 root 3 plus root 2 is there. It's 1 by x, it's reciprocal. We are getting root 3 minus root 2. Their product is 1, see. If their product is 1, 1 is reciprocal of the other. Okay, so here they asked you to find x square plus 1 by x square. Here don't calculate x square and 1 by x square, it will take more time. So we have to apply some algebraic identities. Here x plus 1 by x whole square means a square plus b square plus 2ab, a into b. X and 1 by x, it will get cancelled. So x square plus 1 by x square means how will you calculate? That will be equal to x plus 1 by x whole square plus 2 if you transpose to this side minus 2. This you can use and you can find this value. X we have given, they have root 3 plus root 2. 1 by x you found that reciprocal is root 3 minus root 2 when these two radicands are two consecutive numbers. Minus 2, this is whole square is there here. Here plus root 2 minus root 2 will get cancelled. Root 3 plus root 3. X plus x. 2x like that. 2 root 3 you will get whole square minus 2. So what we are going to get? Here whole square means 2 square 4. Root 3 whole square 3. 4 times 3 you will get. That is 12 minus 2. 10 you are going to get. Okay, its value is x square plus 1 by x square is 10. We have to solve like this. Not only this, some competitive exams, some big problems will be given which can be solved in very less time. See, I'll give one more example. See, 1 upon 3 minus root 8, 3 plus root 8, root 8 plus root 7, root 7 plus root 6, root 6 plus root 5. Root 5 plus root 4 means 2 I can write. See here, see. If the radicands are two consecutive numbers, then the reciprocals we know. X is given means it's reciprocal 1 by x we know. That root 3 plus root 2 is there means here root 3 minus root 2 you will get. Here 3 plus root 8 is there means 3 minus root 8 you will get.
You will get straight away you can write 3 minus root 8. Okay, they are reciprocal, see, 1 by x value, that is. If you are having any doubt, one value will calculate. 1 by 3 minus root 8, no? Here, what is the rationalizing factor? 3 plus root 8. Denominator, you will get 1, see, why? Because they are reciprocals to each other. 3 plus root 8. Here, a minus b into a plus b. A square minus b square we have to use. A square, 3 square means 9. root 8 whole square means 8. So 3 plus root 8 by 1 will be.
Similarly for others also like that only.
Here what is the reciprocal means? Root 8 minus root 7 upon 1 you will get. Here straight away you can write because they are consecutive numbers there. Root 7 minus root 6. Here root 6 minus root 5. That one root 5 minus root 2. Here this also consecutive number. This is root 9 you can write. That 2 is also consecutive number. 5 and 4 are. Because 2 you can write as under root of 4. See here plus root 8 minus root 8. Plus root 7 minus root 7. Plus root 6 minus root 6. Plus root 5 minus root 5 will get cancelled. So finally 3 minus 2 equal to 1.
Within seconds you have to solve. Okay, like that binomial, trinomials we can discuss. Or one more question we can discuss in binomial itself of different order. Okay. First we will go with 1.
Binomial itself we will finish. One more example. 5th question, no? 6th like that we will do. That is 2 power 1 by 3 plus 2 power minus 1 by 3. One example I will take.
Here root a plus root b not like that. It is whole power 1 by 3 is there. It is cubed root.
So what we have to do? A is 2 power 1 by 3 I will take like that. Then a cube will be. If you cube it. Cube and cube root will get cancelled. No, you will get 2. B is 2 power minus 1 by 3. That implies b cube will be 2 power minus 1. 2 power minus 1 nothing but 1 by 2. So now a cube plus b cube if you see. 2 plus 1 upon 2 that is 5 upon 2. Here a cube plus b cube you will get a rational number. And a cube plus b cube you know the rational lizing factors in polynomials chapter we have learned, that is a plus b times a square minus ab plus b square. So a plus b is there, its rationalizing factor will be a square minus ab plus b square c. Now we will come to the actual problem. They have given this 2 power 1 by 3 plus 2 power minus 1 by 3. So what is its rationalizing factor we taught?
A square,
2 power 1 by 3 whole square, that 2 power 2 by 3 will get. Minus AB. A means 2 power 1 by 3. B means 2 power minus 1 by 3. A into B. Plus B square is there. This we have to square. 2 power minus 2 by 3. If you multiply only denominator, the value will change, no? You have to multiply this with numerator also. 2 power 2 by 3 minus 2 power 1 by 3 times 2 power minus 1 by 3 plus 2 power minus 2 by 3. So we multiplied numerator and denominator with a square minus ab plus b square c. So numerator 2 power 2 by 3 minus. See here exponents formula you have to use. A power n into a power m. That is a power n plus m. 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 if you add, you will get 0. 2 power 0 means 1. Straight away we can write 1. Here a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square means a cube plus b cube will it is. That is 2 power 1 by 3 whole cube plus 2 power minus 1 by 3 whole cube. See, already we have calculated a cube plus b cube value. It is 5 by 2. You can write here 5 by 2. Straight away you can write it here a cube plus by cube like that. You can write 5 by 2 here. See. So we got a rational number. If you want this 5 by 2, you can take to numerator. We can write reciprocal 2 by 5 like that. You have rationalized the denominator, no? So we have to rationalize the denominator like this. If cubed roots are there. Okay. Suppose here a minus b is there. Then a cube minus b cube we have to get means one factor is a minus b, the another factor is a square plus ab plus b squares. You have to multiply with this. This is the rationalizing factor for a minus b.
Cube roots are there means that time.
See, we will end with this one interesting problem, that is trinomial. Only one example we will give and we will end this session. So that is at higher order, see. Binomial, you know, trinomial we have to see. Okay, last root 5 plus root 3 or minus we will take, minus 1 like that. So what we have to do, we have to group here. Minus I will take common, so that root 3 plus 1 it will come. A minus, root A minus root B is there, means it is easy, no? Its rationalizing factor will be root A plus root B. So like that I will do. Here these two terms I will consider as one term. Okay, now what I can do, minus is there, so its rationalizing factor will be plus will come, plus root 3 plus 1. You have to multiply the numerator also with the same thing, multiply numerator and denominator with this. Here you can apply a minus b into a minus b formula, a minus b into a plus b, that is a square minus b square. Numerator we are having this, denominator a square means root 5 whole square, b square means root 3 plus 1 whole square. Okay, next see, here see, here square and square root 5 will come. Here what you have to do, you have to use a plus b whole square formula. A square means root 3 whole square, b square means 1 square, plus 2ab, 2 root 3 will get. So 4 plus 2 root 3 will get. But when you give this minus sign, take this minus sign, it will become minus 4 minus 2 root 3 c. Now what we are going to get in the denominator, we are having 1 minus 2 root 3 c. See, the rationalization is not completed. We are having irrational number. Still we are having irrational number. So again we have to multiply with the rationalizing factor. Until you get rational number, we have to continue the process. Numerator we are having root 5 plus root 3 plus 1. Denominator 1 minus 2 root 3 is there, no? Same. We have to multiply with 1 plus 2 root 3. We have to multiply numerator and denominator with 1 plus 2 root 3. So here we have to multiply trinomial and binomial. Here we'll apply formula. See, numerator, first we have to multiply with root 5. Root 5 into 1, root 5. Root 5, see, 2, using laws of radicals, root 5 into root 3, root 15. Now I'm multiplying with root 3. Root 3 plus 2, root 3 into root 3, 3. 1 I'm multiplying, 1 plus 2 root 3. All divided by, here I have to use a minus b into a plus b formula like earlier. It is a square minus b square, 1 square, b square means 2 root 3 whole square. See here what and all I can add. See root 5, we do not have any similar side. 2 times root 15. Here root 3 is there, 2 root 3 is there. They are similar side, see, because they are multiples of same irrational number. X plus 2x like that. 3x. So 3 root 3 you can write. 2 times 3 is 6. 6 plus 1, 7. 1 minus. See 2 root 3 whole square means 2 square means 4. Root 3 whole square means 3. That is 12. See 1 minus 12. That is minus 11. You are going to get irrational number. So denominator, if you are having irrational number, we are not bothered about numerator. See. Denominator, we got irrational number. Then we have rationalized the denominator. The process is complete. See, we gave examples for monomials, binomial and trinomials. Hope you, this session is very useful. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe for more videos.